When you speak the English language enough, you start coming up against these fundamental ambiguities that you can't really get around. They're intractable. Here's an example. I hit the guy with the chair. So just by itself, that statement, if I said that to you, that could mean two separate things. One, it could mean I hit the guy with the chair. So there's a guy over there with a chair and I hit him. And the second meaning is I hit the guy with the chair, meaning using the chair, I hit the guy. Isolated by itself, that sequence of characters means those two separate things, which is ambiguity, which we cannot have in mathematics. It leads to a bunch of stuff breaking. And so classic mathematics came up with an elegant solution to the problem using a very simple tool, which I'll go over after this short intro. The fundamental problem is what is associated with what? We have the man, the chair, and I. So is it I hit the man with the chair, or did I hit the man with the chair? And this can be solved using brackets. Kind of a simple tool, I know, but it gets way more abstract. And not in the way that we typically use brackets, but by putting brackets around kind of things. You thingify stuff using brackets. So I hit the man is kind of a thing, with the chair is another thing. Or I hit the man with the chair. Now this doesn't solve all the problems. I could find a ton of different edge cases where this does not fit, but in a lot of scenarios it actually does help a lot with understanding what someone's writing, what someone's reading about. Now this actually does come into the math part. In abstract algebra, they introduce this idea of associativity. So A, B, C. You define a set and a given operation on that set. And if you haven't seen any abstract algebra yet, go watch my video on that. It's a decent introduction if you like vibesy introductions. But basically you go A, B, C, or A, B, C, and they can be fundamentally different things. And the connection to language as I was studying algebra was just so clear, because especially when reading like dense philosophical texts and stuff like that, you get a lot less confusion. For me, all the time, I'd be stuck on a page with some philosophy book for like a long time, because I'm like, what is he even trying to say? Because they're using abstract words to describe abstract ideas, and there's like something, 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 this thing, and then something, 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 this thing, but it's not clear what associates with what. And so brackets just would really nicely solve that problem. Alas, there's many structural issues that have been tried to be solved in the English language, it turns out, historically, and it's never really happened because it's just custom dictates that we keep using the same language. I'm not against it though. English is pretty good, the language I was born with. Yeah, definitely could use some updating. Brackets, that's my proposition. Brackets added to the English language, use them instead of just a non-canonical addition to whatever text you're writing, and turn them into a way to thingify the phrases. I think that would be hype. I'd be down. Without further ado, take it easy. I love you. Godspeed. And I'll see you in the next one, where we're probably going to be on Math Boat. And that's going to be tomorrow.